welcome to the November edition of Network on Television, NTV. I'm Henry Yates.
And I'm Sharon Bennett.
Today we're at the North Service Center, where 400 of our employees are based.
All over the utility, we're working to best serve our customers.
And here at the North Service Center, that's meant some physical changes, like adding mobile office units, and personnel changes, like restructuring crew assignments. Earlier, I talked with Al Powell, who moved from South Service Center this spring as manager of North Electrical Service and Construction. I asked Al how changes at the service centers help us serve our customers better.
Here at the North Service Center, we're able to respond to all the people in the north of Seattle. We're able to address their problems throughout the day as they occur. We don't have to communicate through downtown to get this done. We're closer to our work sites for travel in the morning. You get a longer work day from this.
Since both service centers are home to a variety of units, we'll be bringing you more service center-based reports in future editions of NTV.
In order to maintain our utility systems, activity never stops. At a test site north of the Duwamish substation, City Light crews and the EMF work group take an active role in research to evaluate electromagnetic fields, or EMF, and their effect on human health. Crews move lines into different configurations, and Joji uses a special computer, Linda, to measure fields.
Linda is a magnetic field meter that I use to measure the field levels here at the Duwamish test site, and eventually perhaps propose some new innovative line construction to mitigate electromagnetic fields.
Next, we're going to turn our attention way up north to the Skagit. Henry, we've both been up at Skagit recently, and there's been a lot of changes up there.
Yes, Sharon, and those changes will be even more apparent this summer, thanks to the phenomenal efforts that occurred in October.
We went up to Diablo, where it seemed nearly everyone was involved in the drawdown, lowering the lake level for some long-needed maintenance. Diablo Lake was lowered 22 feet, uncovering shore surfaces that hadn't seen daylight in 4 years. Crews used the opportunity to tackle several urgent jobs.
Putting in the new tour dock and the new tour facilities was the original reason for the drawdown. We took advantage of the drawdown to fix gate 3 on Diablo Dam, change all the chains out from the gates on Diablo Dam. The steel crew and the heavy construction crew mainly did that. And we did a lot of maintenance that we haven't been able to do simply because normally it would be under 20 feet of water.
Teamwork and timing was critical, requiring coordination from the powerhouses and from the PCC in Seattle. Every time a barge goes into this narrow section of Diablo Lake, Ross Powerhouse must be shut down. A cold snap that very morning left Seattle shivering, so the schedule was adjusted to keep power flowing. The barge and concrete truck waited a little longer to get the job done on time. The projects at Diablo involved at least 60 employees from different areas of the utility. All were coordinated to work together. That's teamwork.
Teamwork is a part of everything we do as a utility, and that's urgently evident when it comes to safety. Line crews keep safety in mind constantly while on the job. They never know when this scenario will become a reality and they'll have to save a life. The annual Pole Top Rescue Competition keeps their skills in CPR and life-saving in top shape, and it's not just to win a statewide competition either.
It's important to keep this program alive, to keep people interested in safety, to keep people trained and to the fact to where they're almost like a machine if an accident would ever occur to where they would have to go and rescue one of their co-workers.
And practicing CPR and the rescue over and over again, I hope that if that ever happened to me, I wouldn't even have to think about it. I'd just know exactly what to do.
Strategic planning is essential for our path of continuous improvement as a utility.
One of the first ways this has become apparent is in the creation of the Strategic Technology and Planning Division formed in the October reorg. Norm Ahlberg heads the group.
The superintendent's reorganization that took place October 1st essentially combined ISD, the old Information Systems Division, and the newer productivity creation of the Corporate Performance Division into one single division. The new Strategic Technology and Planning Division will be responsible for all of the functions that those two separate divisions were responsible for and bring them together. Another additional change that was added to the new Strategic Technology and Planning Division is coordinating the utility's research and development projects, the research and development budget.
The reorg and delayering will positively develop new reporting roles and clarify direction with a minimum amount of downsizing in staff. However, the warm winter reduced revenues and surplus power. Despite a surcharge, rate increase for customers, and budget cuts for 1993-94, some positions will be abrogated by the end of the year.
Well, even with the hiring freeze, the city is allowing us, because someone's affected by a budget cut, that the positions will be abrogated. They've allowed us to laterally transfer those people into positions that are vacant. And those people that are in abrogated positions, if in fact there's a position that calls for a promotion, well, they have to go through an interview process and determine whether in fact they're qualified for that job. If they are, then that has to go down to OMB and city personnel for a waiver approval. But the priority is to take those people that are on the abrogate list and put them in the jobs laterally without going through the waiver process.
Even though as a utility we are facing budget shortfalls, as individuals we once again opened up our hearts and our wallets to help those in need. The Combined Charities campaign always brings out creative ways for City Light employees to raise money. And this year is no exception. From a new image fair enhancing looks and exploring recreation to a guest appearance from Robin Hood and his Merry Pranksters, the enthusiasm City Light folks show for this event deserves special recognition. We appreciate hearing from those of you who took the time to call with your suggestions for NTV. Next month, you'll be hearing about your response to the employee survey and what that means.
And we'd like to hear from more of you. Give us a call at Community Relations, 684-3112, or jot down your ideas and send them to NTV, room 809, Seattle City Light Building.
We'd like to know what issues you'd like to see covered on NTV. For NTV, I'm Henry Yates.
And I'm Sharon Bennett.